Sometimes learning can be a little difficult, and we know that. So that's why we are here, guys. We try and see how we can crack this learning thing. Welcome back again to my YouTube channel. My name is Christine. And if you are new here, you know how we do it. Kindly subscribe, like, and don't forget to share. So today we are going to look at taking off quantities of a door. And it's a flush door, guys. So we want to look at how we are going to measure the quantities of a flush door. So this is our door that we have. We have 900 by 2100. So this one includes the frame, the door frame. So the 900 and 21 length and width respectively include the frame of the door. And then we've been told the door is 45 millimeters thick, same solid flush door. And then we have been shown a 100 by 25 softwood skirting. So this is elevation. So we want to look at the elements of the door and how we are going to take off the quantities of the door. Now, without wasting a lot of time, let's start. So we are going to start with the items that we are going to measure. So we'll need this door frame, that door frame. We need the architrave. Architrave is here. Architrave is that timber that supports the door frame. So that architrave, it's there. It's 34 by 14 millimeters. And then we have the quadrant. Quadrant is that mold that we use for decorating the door. And then we have the door itself, that is the door leaf, this part here. We have the ironmongery. Then we have the lintel, we have reinforcement and adjustment for openings. So this is section MM. So if you look at section MM, we have the 45 millimeters door, and then we have our frame, and then we have the architrave, then we have the mold. This is the mold here. Sorry, this is the mold. As you can see, it's kind of a decoration. And then on top of the door is where we have the lintel. So the lintel is made of concrete and reinforced steel bars. So we are going to take that one. And then on top of the lintel is the wall. So we are going to do that. So let's start with door frame. Our item number one is door frame. So for the door frame, we need the length. The length, that is the length and the height of the door frame. So the length is 900, and then the height, sorry, this is 2100. So it's 2100 this side and 2100 that side. When you add that one, it gives you 5100. And then this frame, it has horns here that are projecting inside like that, and on this side like that. So we are going to add 50. We are going to assume here is 50. No, we are going to assume is 75. So 275 is 150. So that gives us 2250. Now we book that one. Sorry, 5250. Now we book that one, 5.25, this one here. And then we say 100 by 50 solid frame with two laborers. Now we go to architrave. This is our architrave here. So the architrave is surrounding the frame, but it's not up to this point where we have a skirting. So we are going to take this height and this length and this height up to here for the architrave. Now we had the length without horns, that was from here up, and then the width and the height was 5100, that was without the horns. And then we deduct the skirting, that is 100. This timber here, it's 100. So here is 100, that is where we have our 100. So we deduct that one, so it's going to give us, we are going to deduct 100 this side and 100 that side, that is 4900. And then we proceed and book that one, 4.90. we say that 8 by 14 millimeters stone wood softwood architrave with two lamps. And then the architrave, where we have the architrave here is where we are going to also have our mold. our quadrant mould on top of the architrave, so they share the same dimension. So we say upper sand 25 millimeters softwood quadrant mould. Now we go to the door leaf. Now this is the door leaf here. So our length, our height, yeah, that is our height, is 2100. Yes, we less the frame. Now 2100 is from here up to here. That is where we have 2100. But our door is going to come into up to this point. You see, when our door is placed, this is our frame, but the entire frame does not, the entire frame does not flush with the door here. No, we have this cutting here so that we can have our door here from this point downwards. So that one can be our door. Now what we do, we take our frame. So our frame was 100. Now we are going to less frame. We are going to say this part here, we are going to say is 37 millimeters. So we are going to subtract that 7 from what we had, that is 2100, from top here up to here was 2100. And then there's a tolerance of 3. We are going to give a tolerance of 3. So we subtract that one, we get 2060. Now that is for the height. For the width, we had 900, and then we are going to less the frame on this side, the same thing that we have done on this side and on this side. That gives us 2 by 37, so that is going to be 826. And then, so this is going to be the size of the door, 2060 by 826. So we are going to say 1 45 millimeters thick semi solid flush door, size 826 by 2060 millimeters high, with interior quality plywood, including 10 millimeter softwood leapings on all four edges. So we proceed to the ironmongery. So we are going to have 1 mortise lock as union for locking the door. We are going to have 25 millimeters diameter rubber stopper. That is the one that controls the doors when it's moving in and out. And then we are going to have the bolts, 100 millimeters. And then we are going to have the metal fixing clamps. So these ones, we are going to have 5 of them for fixing the door. So this ironmongery, you are not being given on the section and plan, but you know how the door is fixed. So from your general building knowledge, you can be able to to derive the ironmongeries that we need for that door. Now we go to the lintel. The lintel here, we have our concrete. Now the length is 900, the width of the window is 900, and then we add, so 900 is from here up to here, but you're not going to put our lintel up to the width, that is 900. So we are going to add bearings. These are bearings that project in, protrude outside. We are going to assume 200 200, so we add that one, we get 1300. So our length would be 1300, the thickness of the lintel is 200, and then the height is also 200. So it's a 1.30, 0.20, 0.220. VRC in 1 is to 2 is to 4 in 20 millimeters aggregates in the lintel. Now we go to reinforcement. If you look at this lintel that we have 2 number 12 millimeters mild steel bars, these ones here. So we have those bars. So we are going to find the length. Now the bars are going to be up to here. So here is where we are going to have our reinforcement on this lintel here. So that is 1300. The length was 1300. We less cover 225. That gives us 1250. And then 1250, we add 200 for the bends. These bends here is going to be 1650. Yes, 1650. Now we are going to, there are how many? There are 2, and then we have 2. So those are 4. Now this is going to be 1450. So that is 1300, and then plus, yes, 1300 minus 225, that gives us 1250. Plus 200, that is 1450. So 1.45, and then there are four in number. You say 12 millimeter diameter milestone reinforced BS, including bending, cutting, and fixing. Yeah. Now we go to formwork. So formwork to the soffits and the sides of the lintel. So for the sides, we are going to have the sides is where we have, if this is our lintel, this is the side and the other one. So there are two. So that is 1.3 what we had for the concrete. And then the thickness of the lintel is this one is 200. And then on the width, we had 0.9 by 0.2. This is for the sides. Sorry, this is for the soffit. Okay, let's repeat that one. For the soffit, it's down. So we are going to have down here. Yeah, this is was 1300, and then the width is 200. And then for the sides, we are going to have this is 900 by 200, and then the other side is 900 by 200. So there are two. And then you say stone timber formwork to the soffits of the sides of the lintel. And then adjustment to openings, we have that opening 0.90 by 2.1. So that opening, that entire opening of the window, so we need to take care of that one, 21 by 900. And then we have also for the lintel, that is 1.3 by 0.25. so we say 200 millimeters thick CBC wall. We deduct from the measurements that we had, and then we also deduct 0.9, that is for the frame, 100 by 25 millimeters. We deduct that one, the length, the width of the frame. So guys, that is how we do it. Until next time, see you, and thank you very much. Kindly keep subscribing, keep sharing, keep commenting. Help us so that we may be able to grow together.